I think that we have around 13-14 minutes. We'll have to take the question and answer session because my notes didn't get much time. So now we will open this house for questions. To introduce yourself and get a pointed question so that three of the presenters can answer pointed questions.
और आप बताएं कि आप कहाँ से हैं, अपना नाम और आपकी संस्था से जुड़े हुए बताएं।
My name is Amlesh Pandey and I
use the mic.
My name is Amlesh Pandey. I am student of Political Geography Division, CBOARD SIS, JNU only. And my question to ma'am is, ma'am, does diaspora plays any role in determining policies and bilateral relations between two countries?
Other questions?
Dr. Mukesh Mahanji, my question is one, the role of gender participation of male or female are same percentage or it may be differ? The participation of gender is same or
Now you spoke about the multiplicity of diasporic identity being highly different from the multiplicity of identities in general. So my question is that today we are living in a highly globalized world. How does this multiplicity of diasporic identity differ from multiplicity of identity in a country like America, where from a melting pot it has actually changed itself into a salad bowl where all the cultures have their separate place?
Any other?
Different places. If we look at the Indian history, then we might find that everyone is a diaspora in that case. So how should we take our own identities?
Okay, so we'll have other round to other presenters. Now, Madam.
Okay,
I briefly
started sawalon ka jawab dungi. Ye jo role of diaspora in bilateral relations hai, you know, this is actually that's what I was trying to point out, you know, that they are very tangible entities in this world, you know, which are playing very important roles in IR and as well as in economic participation, you know. Yes, there is a big role for diasporas in bilateral relations, you know. When I talk about this multiple belongingness, belonging to the homeland also and the hostland also, that's a very, very important factor. Because if diasporas are ambassadors of Indian culture in America, they are also the ambassadors of American culture in India. So when Jacob Zuma visits India, he brings at least 10 Indian diaspora people in his delegation. Because of the familiarity of the with India, of the among these people, and their networks, which they can use to increase India-South Africa relations, you know. And it is same in the U.S. also. When India was signing nuclear deal, the diaspora in U.S. played a very, very important role in that deal. They played a very important role in educating the American culture of the importance India has in the present world, you know, and how America's relations with India is going to benefit America also, not only India. You know. So diasporas do play a very, very important role, and they are there in thick and thin of most of the countries where they are there, and that is the one of the very significant roles Indian diaspora has, you know. It goes beyond the soft power. They are now part of the hard power of India, you know. So that one has to remember. About gender roles, yes, you know, it is a very, very interesting subject because for a very long time, migration was gender blind. people were migrating, all the experiences, everything was from the male side, as if women were just following. And it was very late that this thing came into existence, and now women's experience are being highlighted in different studies, and yes, their role is very, very different. Very different. Although now they are also being part of the hard power. When I say, you know, all the time I'm talking about hard power also, because for a very long time, वो हमारा culture ले जा रहे हैं और हमारा बहुत मान बढ़ रहा है. ये सब बहुत बातें हो गई. महिलाएं अब बिल्कुल इस दुनिया का हिस्सा है जहां वो इकोनॉमिकली पॉलिटिकली एवरी वाइज दे आर प्लेइंग अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल एंड सेम इज द डायस्पोरा. द न्यू थिंग इज दैट नाउ देयर एक्सपीरियंसेस आर बीइंग हाइलाइटेड द वे मेल एक्सपीरियंसेस वर. तो ये बहुत समय तक अगर महिलाओं की बात होती थी तो कहा जाता था कि कैरियर्स ऑफ इंडियन ट्रेडिशन. No, they are more than that. They are more than that, you know. They are careers of Indian tradition, but they are more than that. So, ये मैं कह रही हूँ highlight होने लगा. और जो आप कह रहे थे कि छुपाते हैं identity या बताते हैं, ये बड़ा interesting सवाल है. आप हजारों cases देखेंगे जहाँ उनको इतना ज़्यादा racial discrimination face करना पड़ता है most countries में कि वो उन्हें अपनी identity छुपाना पड़ता है. जब ये शुरू में ये IIT engineers गए थे तो उनको प्रमोशन नहीं मिलता था क्योंकि वो तो इंडियन ओरिजिन के हैं. उन्होंने जो डिस्कार्ड किया इंडियननेस वो किस लिए भी किया ताकि वो वहाँ पे प्रोग्रेस कर पाए. लेकिन याद रखिए इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि उन्होंने इंडिया को भुला दिया था. आप भारतीय जो भारत आईटी इंडस्ट्री में जो इंडियन आईटी इंडस्ट्री का हिस्ट्री पढ़ी है तो आपको समझ में आएगा कि कितना स्ट्रगल किया है डायस्पोरिक पॉपुलेशन ने टू हेल्प इंडिया टू ग्रो इन आईटी सेक्टर. यू नो वो छुपा छुपा के उनको कॉन्ट्रैक्ट देते थे, आउटसोर्सिंग करते थे. जब हेड बन जाते थे इंस्टीट्यूशंस के यूएस में तो छुप के आईटी आउटसोर्सिंग जो है वो इंडियन कंपनीज को देते थे. You know, so this is, you know, it never goes out. The home exists in different ways in their mind, you know. And that is why I would say that the manifestation of home is different for every community. So please don't think ki wo wapas laut ke aayega tabhi ghar hai. Nahi, ghar hai uska. Wo kahin hai uske dimaag mein. Ghar ke jo jahan se uska origin hua hai. Achha, multiplicity of identities kisi ne pucha tha? Haan. Ki, you said that how it is different, you know. This is where it is different, you know. When you migrate, there is a, yes, we are influenced by American culture so much. Hamara to McDonald's bhi hai, ye bhi hai, wo bhi hai, everything. But the core of identity, you know, what we take, we take. What we don't want, we don't want. The diasporic identities are created in these middle spaces, you know. The core of the identities are these middle spaces. और हम जितना ही समझेंगे हम उतना ही इस तरह के सवालों से बच पाएंगे कि वो किस भाषा में लिख रहे हैं. हम क्यों समझें कि वो हमारी भाषा में लिखे. आप इंडो आप फिजी में जाएंगे तो उनकी अपनी भाषा जो इंडो फिजियन है उसमें वो साहित्य लिख रहे हैं. वो आपसे बहुत डिफरेंट भाषा है. आपको समझ नहीं आएगा लेकिन वो उनकी भाषा है. वो और वो अपने आप को बहुत हिंदुस्तानी मानते हैं. लाइक मैम सेड उनको उनके पास भी एक पूरा प्रिस्क्रिप्शन रहता है कि इंडिया को ये करना चाहिए वो करना चाहिए. उनको लगता है वो इंडिया में होते तो कहाँ से कहाँ पहुँचा दिया होता उन्होंने इंडिया को, यू नो. तो दैट इज देयर. सो उसको उस डाइवर्सिटी को जरा अगर हम ध्यान में रखेंगे तो हम ज़्यादा जस्टिस कर पाएंगे उनके उनके लिटरेचर के साथ. ये बहुत सोचने की बात है.
Now we have only 5 minutes. We'll ask for any brief question to Pula Parler.
Before that,
I request Mehta Sri Talpatra to read out the message.
Dear delegates and organizations of the 2 days national seminar on Indian culture on diaspora literature, jointly organized by Adi Kavi Sarala Das Chair for Odia Studies, Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi, and Sod Samvad Research Forum, Delhi. I must mention that I shall miss the event due to unavoidable appointments in Odisha. The literature of the Indian diaspora has been visible in the canon, which appeared as a subgenre during evolution of globalization, technology, and social, economic, and political treaties internationally. Henceforth, diaspora literature may not be considered as a minority discourse of the canon, but as a formation of the major point of view across borders. The global diasporic literature, which has been an outcome of migration of various communities and individuals during colonization and later, has a major segment of cultural markers which needs an urgent examination. However, the cultural segments are not free from the market economy and social audience. On this context, the Indian diaspora writing may be considered from prospective cultural turning points during evolution of multi-ethnic cultures around the globe. The two-day seminar think tank shall contemplate over the formation of Indian cultural markers of the Indian diaspora writing and examine it historically, which shall add to ongoing debates. I express my sincere thoughts and wish a successful deliberation of the national seminar and welcome again all delegates and organizers on behalf of Adi Kavi Sarala Das Chair for Oriya Studies, Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi.
Very interesting message in the Japanese message came.